Hey guys, and crazy here. Another video on the 2023 Hyundai Elantra N. In the last video, we went ahead and installed the front tow hook, and I showed you guys how that was all done and where I got it from. So if you haven't seen that and you're interested in doing something like that to yours, you can go ahead and check out that video. And video before that, we did some carbon fiber on the interior, and I did go ahead and mention I was waiting for some other pieces to come in. I had the pieces for the center console there, the shifter and the cup holders ordered, but there was a bit of a mix up there, so I had to cancel them and reorder those. So in the meantime, I had a couple other pieces show up. One I did mention is the one that's going to go around the heater controls, so that's gonna be what we're gonna be doing today. And then I did go ahead and order the ones here that go on the steering wheel. So over top of here, they're gonna go on their carbon fiber as well. So yeah, I did get those in the mail here last week, and unfortunately I wasn't able to post anything the past couple weeks because, I mean, the weather was actually really great for it here. Unfortunately, the mix up at the parts there was kind of what held me up. So, but today we're gonna go ahead and unbox these babies here and throw them in and show you guys how that's done. So we'll go ahead and get you set up here so you can kind of see what I'm doing. And yeah, so I did order these off of AliExpress. And they were pretty quick. They shipped, they were here to Canada in I think just a little less than a couple weeks. So packaged pretty good. Came with some bubble wrap on the pieces here for the steering wheel. Little insert they threw in just to help it, so I guess it didn't buckle or nothing in there. So that was nice. So a little extra care in the packaging. That's nice to see. So that's them there. Got a razor blade here. We'll go ahead and these open. Hopefully you can kind of see what I'm doing here. So like everything else I've already put in, they're just they're 3M, super easy to do. So you just yeah, they look nice too. Quality is nice and they look to be in good shape. Just some little pieces of 3M on it there on the back. And I did go ahead already and warm up the car, warm up the interior, and I took some isopropyl alcohol on a microfiber and just kind of cleaned up the pieces there before we go ahead and stick these on, just so there's no oil or dirt or anything like that in there. So yeah, that's those pieces for the steering wheel. And then here is the piece that goes and around the heater controls. Nice too. Hopefully the camera's picking that up a little bit. But yeah, so that is them in a nutshell there. Like I said, I'll have the link down in the description for them if anybody else is interested in going ahead and picking them up for their Elantra. So yeah, let's get straight to it, I guess. Let's probably throw this guy on here first. So like I said before in the other video, since it's a little cold here still, I got the heater going here a little bit so I can heat these up and I'll move you guys in a bit here. I like to use a razor blade. Helps to get the edge up on the pieces there. Thank you. All right, I got them all off now. I'm actually just gonna go ahead and heat them up a little bit here on the heater, just because, like I said, it is a little cold here, so let's get them a little more tacky so they stick better. So I have had some problems with the 3M on some of the pieces. That's one thing I didn't mention, and I probably should have in the other videos, is that sometimes the 3M's not the best. So if you want to go out and purchase something a little better and just peel it and put your own stuff on, it's not a bad idea to do. All right, well, let's go ahead and hop in here and fire it up and see if we can get this first piece put on. Oh. Set up here in the best spot so you can see what I'm doing. All right, looks like she just goes on like so. So pretty simple, guys. Just put it on, and until you're happy with the way it's sitting, just don't fully push it down. If it sticks a little much, you can pull it back. It's not a big deal. Just get it on there until you feel you're happy with it. For me, it seems like it fell right into place pretty easy, guys. Like most of the stuff that I have bought, it does line up pretty darn well. They've done a good job. I mean, they're not super cheap for these guys. This one I think was around $80, and the steering wheel pieces were I think around 45 or so. But you just go around and press it down real good, and not a big deal, man. There it is. So let me know what you guys think. Like I said, I'm gonna have the pieces for here coming yet, and the cup holder as well. And I did go ahead and order the one for the I guess the old shit handle, or whatever you want to call it here. So that one should be showing up fairly soon. So let's go ahead and peel the ones for the steering wheel here and see how they fit. Get you guys set back up here again. So this one here is going to be this one here will be for the driver's side. This one here. So even smaller little bits of 3M on these ones can be a little hard to peel. That's why I like to use the razor. It does help to get the edge up as a little side trick. This one. Helps if you have some fingernails to grab it. Alright, so got that one all peeled. Let's go ahead and see if we can get her in here. Alright. So hopefully, like the rest of them, it's probably just gonna hopefully fall into place on its own for the most part. And yeah, that's pretty much what has happened here, guys. Like I said, no issues with the fit up of most of the parts I've put in. Maybe you know, like this time of year when it's cold, obviously it's better to do this when it's warmer out, but yeah, that's her. That's one down, so that's kind of the before and the after, which I really like. So let's go ahead and get that last one unpeeled. And we will throw that one on the other side of the steering wheel. Hopefully that's not too loud in the background there. I got the garage door open and I do live on a main road, so some traffic going past. But it's nice out and it adds a bit of light to my garage. It's a little dark in here. I've got some upgrading to do to the garage, which I'll be doing in springtime, and making it a lot more efficient in here to use. Until then, you make do with what you got, and that's the way she goes. So there you go, boys. That one is all peeled now. Let's go ahead and throw that in, and oh. So once again, super easy. It just seems to pretty much drop right into place on its own for the most part. So you just lightly kind of let it fall in, and once you're kind of happy with it, just go ahead and start pushing her down. As long as your buttons are clearing nice and nothing's interfering there, which everything seems to function, so it's in the right spot. It's not dragging on any of the buttons. And yeah, there you go. Voila, more carbon fiber to the interior. Looking forward to this piece showing up here and then getting the cup holders and everything next. So other than that, I did go ahead and order some other parts, more on the performance end of it, not tuning wise, just drivability wise. So I'll save those for another video. Those are going to be coming up here soon. Also, exciting news for myself is I had a company reach out to me by the name of Atomic Car Concepts, and they sent me some really cool stuff, and I just got that in the mail here on Friday. So in the next video, I'm going to be doing an unboxing of the stuff they sent me and kind of going over some stuff about Atomic Car Concepts and some of the products that they have. And we'll just leave it at that for now. And so super excited about that as well. You know, being obviously a super small channel here for the car, that kind of just fired up. Thought that was pretty neat that they gave me an opportunity to show some of their stuff. So very excited about that, guys. Other than that, as you can see, the weather here, it was looking good. We did have a good dump of snow, but you know, it's still fairly nice out here today temperature wise. And I did go ahead and put the insurance back on the Elantra. So as soon as the roads are kind of nice enough, I mean, I could get out on them right now. They're, you know, the main roads are pretty clear. They're just wet, but you know, I don't want to be in too much of a hurry. I do have the ceramic coat and all the, you know, the PPE and everything done on the front of the car, but you know, she's a beauty also as well. And it's hard to drive your new car in the crappy weather. But anyways, guys, without rambling on too much, that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed that, and let me know what you think about the carbon fiber, and I'll have the links in the description if you're interested in picking any of it up. But yeah, let me know what you think of it, and I think it looks good, and for the price, you know, and if a guy doesn't like it down the road and you want to switch things up, that's the nice part about 3M stuff, is you can just take it back off. So other than that, guys, we will catch you in the next one. So take care. Bye-bye.